Hi everybody, it's me, Susie Kadoozy. I'm back with my vlog. Okay, so today I want to vlog about being quiet. Ironic, huh? Because I'm going to talky-talky. But I was just thinking, I learn in life from the most basic things. And when I was learning about meditation, this lady said to me, all right, put it this way, Sue, it's as simple as this. God gave you one mouth and two ears for a reason. And for whatever, I don't know what, it just hit me that, oh, I get it. Yeah, we're not supposed to talk as much as we listen. But it's taken me so long to slow down because I was born with this disease that I don't know if you people have it, but it's called diarrhea of the mouth, where I would just talk and talk and talk. And it's funny because coming to the end of like really realizing what my show Minus 32 Million Words is about, I'm realizing that the whole time I'm the only one on stage and I'm doing all the talking because that's what I've done my whole life. I have talked and talked and talked and talked and talked to fill up all the space. And most of the time, the people that I was talking to either were telling me nice things or they weren't listening to me at all. And it didn't matter because I wasn't experiencing any of it. So that being said, I want to talk about a time in my life when I was so scared that I thought I was going to die. A lot of times things have to do with money with me, like these spiritual experiences, because I always used to think that if I just had money, then everything would be okay. So everybody knows from listening to me on What the Fuck that I ran out of all my money. I had no money whatsoever. And one day during the summer, I literally had no money. I was waiting for a check or something, or I was doing a spot the next night. I had nothing. I was living on my friend's couch. I had a one-way ticket to Long Beach. It was summertime, and I was like, I'm not going to live like this. I'm not. I'm not going to be miserable. And I got on the train, and I went to Long Beach. And I'm walking along the boardwalk, and I hear, Sue Costello. And I turn around, and it's a bunch of guys that I know from the city. And they're like, come on, come hang with us. And I sit down, and they have this cooler full of food, and we ate. We had a great time, and they're like, Sue, do you want to ride home? And they gave me a ride home, and I remember that night. It was almost like life forced me to sit still. I couldn't do anything that night. I think I cried for like 2 days. It was the most profound spiritual experience I ever had. I couldn't believe that at a time when I thought I had nothing, I was given more than I could ever imagine. And I was only given it was only given to me because I decided to change. I was like, I can't be miserable. And I can think of a million times when I was in Hollywood and I had tons of money in the bank and I was so mad. I was so miserable. I was so angry. I had not cleared up any of my past. I couldn't slow down. I just kept going fast and fast and fast and fast. And I would talk. And the other thing I realized too, this is the most important thing, that sometimes when you meditate, it helps you out in the world because you actually can listen to what's really going on and experience it the way it is instead of projecting all your own stuff onto it. Like, I cannot believe how much I can sit still. And let me tell you, I have been provoked. Sometimes I get so provoked. Like, I used to literally punch people in the face if they hurt my feelings. And now I can sit still and watch somebody and just be like, wow, that's really, really mean what that person's doing. And you know what's crazy about it? Sometimes it takes like 3 days for it to even really sink in. So to be able to sit still and not do anything except accept things for exactly the way they are. My friend from South Boston, he's always like, it is what it is, Sue. And I think only until you sit still can you really realize that it is what it is. And once you realize it is what it is, you can do something about it.